Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. We have discussed about the attribute of Allah Sami' before the break. Now we are going to take two more attributes of Allah: Al-Hakam, the judge, the ruler; Al-Adl, the just. First, a few things about Al-Hakam. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, أَفَغَيْرَ اللَّهِ يَبْتَغِي حَكَمًا وَهُوَ الَّذِي أَنزَلَ إِلَيْكُمُ الْكِتَابَ مُفَصَّلًا. Say that, can I take any other person apart from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as a judge? And He is the one who has given you the book in all details. And He also said in Surah Yusuf, إِنِ الْحُكْمُ إِلَّا لِلَّهِ In al-hukmu illa lillah, the rule is only for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa man ahsanu min Allah hukman liqawmin yuqinun. And is there any rule better than the rule of Allah for those people who got belief, who got the conviction of the faith? And He also said, فَالْحُكْمُ لِلَّهِ الْعَلِيِّ الْكَبِيرِ. So the rule, the judgment is for Allah, who is high, who is great. And He also said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَحْكُمُ مَا يُرِيدُ. Indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala judges whatever He likes. And the end of Surah At-Tin, أَلَيْسَ اللَّهُ بِأَحْكَمِ الْحَاكِمِينَ. Is not Allah the judge of the judges? So the main thing which we understand from this word Al-Hakam, that He is just, and He is the judge who is giving justice, who is giving the judgment with justice. And it implicates three things here. The first thing is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows what happened in the past and what is going to happen in the future. And we have said earlier that for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala there is no past, no future. And when we speak about past and future, that is according to our understanding. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows our past, our present, our future. And the second thing, that His will is a compelling will, which is not going to be frustrated in any way. Nobody can frustrate Him. Nobody can say that His will is going to dominate the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the third stage would be al-qudra an-nafiza, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala got the absolute power to implement what He wanted to implement. So if He wants to give a judgment, this judgment is going to be implemented. It is not like the judgment of some of the judges in our time, that because they got no authority or no power, they can't implement their own judgments. And the fourth thing in this connection is complete justice. Because if there is no complete justice, the hukm of Allah or the hukm of the judge is not going to be accepted. But Allah's judgment is always based upon justice and complete justice. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ قَدْ حَكَمَ بَيْنَ الْعِبَادِ, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given His judgment among the people. What does it mean? For example, the saying of Allah, وَقَضَى رَبُّكَ أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا إِلَّا إِيَّاهِ وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has decreed that you must not worship except Him. And that, وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا, treat your parents with ihsan, very nicely. This is, of course, another issue, that in this ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned the right of Allah first, and then the right of the parents. The right of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is that you worship Him, just Him alone. Don't make any association with Him, no partner, no deity, just Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is what is demanded by Allah. And the second thing is, as far as your parents are concerned, you are not worshipping them, but you are treating them nicely and gently, especially if they are old and they need you, because as they have taken care of you when you were just a child, Now, they are grown up and they are old. They need your assistance. So assist them and help them. Don't say even a word like, oof. Yani, why? To your parents. Why did you say that? You are not supposed to do that, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asked you to be nice to them as they were nice to you when you were just a young lad. Now, this is there is another thing which we understand from this ayah, إِنَّ اللَّهَ قَدْ حَكَمَ بَيْنَ الْعِبَادِ, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He has decreed for some people to be fortunate one and the other people to be unfortunate one. This is known in Arabic as as-sa'adah and as-shaqawa. And we know from one hadith that when the angel is going to blow the soul into the body, that is in the womb of the woman, in the embryo, at that time few things are recorded, and in them is the sustenance of that person, the action of that person, the age of that person, and ashaqiyun huwa am sa'idun, whether he is a wicked person or a fortunate person, that is in the hand of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.